Welcome back. Now we discuss experiment of determining heat transfer coefficient of forced convection. In convection, heat transfer takes place due to bulk motion of fluid, and the motion of fluid is maybe due to buoyancy force or maybe due to external aids like pumps, fan, blower. If the motion of fluid which causes heat transfer by convection is due to buoyancy force, and buoyancy force is created due to density difference, and density difference is caused due to temperature difference, then the convection is called as natural convection. And if the motion of fluid is due to blower, fan or pump, then the convection is called as forced convection. So our experiment is on forced convection, and aim is to determine heat transfer coefficient experimentally and theoretically, means by using correlation. So this is the setup for the forced convection experiment, in which heat transfer coefficient is determined experimentally and theoretically, means by using correlation. So setup consisting of this pipe. Of half meter length, over which the band heater is provided for heating the pipe, and on the pipe surface we have 6 thermocouple at equal interval to measure the temperature of the pipe, and pipe is connected to the blower outlet. With the help of this blower, air is supplied through the pipe, such that when air is flowing through the hot pipe, heat is transferred from the surface of pipe to the air. And as air motion of the air is due to blower, so the experiment heat transfer is by forced convection. So forced convection takes place between the internal surface of the pipe and the fluid flowing through the pipe, means air flowing through the pipe. So this experiment consisting of blower which supplies the required air flow rate in the pipe. This is the delivery valve to control the flow rate of air flowing through the pipe which is heated, and over which the heat transfer coefficients are determined. Then here is one thermocouple, T7, and here is T8, which measure inlet and outlet temperature of air through the pipe. And over the pipe we have 6 thermocouple at equal interval, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. And the air flowing through the pipe, that mass flow rate of air flowing through the pipe, is measured by this orifice meter. So here is orifice meter, and across the orifice meter pressure drop is measured, and that pressure drop is measured by this manometer. So the manometer and orifice meter arrangement is used to measure the flow rate of air flowing through the pipe. Also it is useful to calculate velocity to get the Reynolds number. And here we have controls. So this is the dimmer tap, which is used to control the heat supply to the band heater which is around the pipe, and voltage and current supply to the pipe is given by this ammeter and voltmeter. So electrical power supply is V into I, and to avoid the heat loss from this test pipe, the pipe is insulated by asbestos wool. Then we have here its main switch, which is used to start or stop the setup. Then here is blower switch. Then this is temperature indicator which indicate 8 temperatures, 1 to 6 on the pipe, and 7 measure inlet temperature of air. So this thermocouple is inside the pipe in the airflow, measure inlet temperature of air, and this measure outlet temperature of air. So this thermocouple is also in the air, and 1 to 6 are on the pipe under the band heater. So this temperature indicator indicate 1 to 6 pipe temperature, 7 inlet temperature of air, 8 outlet temperature of air. So this is about the experimental setup. Now we will discuss procedure to conduct the experiment. So this is the main switch. So first this main switch is put on, then the this is another switch or blower, with the help of which blower is started. Now blower is on, and with the help of delivery valve we can set the flow rate, and the flow rate is indicated by orifice and manometer arrangement. Then with the help of this dimmer stack, the heat is supplied to the heater, and in this experiment also we are giving the heat up to 100 volt, means we can give the power. So we can give the power correspond to voltage from 60 to 100 volt with the help of this dimmer stack, and for force convection then we are starting blower. Now blower is on, heater is on, heat is supplied to the pipe, so pipe is get heated, air is flowing through pipe, so heat is transferred to the air by force convection. Now we will wait for steady state, and in this experiment of force convection, in this setup particularly, the steady state is achieved after half an hour. After half an hour you can see that the temperature 1 to 6 remains constant. That means temperature at particular location is not varying with time. The steady state is achieved. When steady state is achieved, we are noting the readings for calculation of heat transfer coefficient. So this is the observation table, which include the temperatures of pipe, which are T1 to T6, which are given by temperature indicator from 1 to 6. Then temperature of air is given by T7 and T8. T7 is inlet temperature, T8 is outlet temperature. Then manometer readings, which is required to calculate mass flow rate of air and volume or velocity. Then we can also record voltage and current, which is not required in calculation, but it can be used for reference for conducting other trials. And this is typical test section. So above we have a band heater, and inside is the pipe, and over the pipe we have 6 thermocouples, and this 7 thermocouple is in the air, and 8 is also in air, and air is flowing through this pipe. So observations include the temperatures 1 to 6 on pipe, 7 and 8 or temperature of air, and manometer readings. Now we will discuss calculation part. So objective in this experiment is to calculate H practically and theoretically. So first we'll discuss the calculation of heat transfer coefficient experimentally, and first we'll discuss the calculation of average heat transfer coefficient. So in convection, heat transfer is given by the formula Q equal to HA TS minus TM, according to Newton's law of cooling. So H is here heat transfer coefficient by force convection, which we want to determine. A is surface area from which heat is transferred to the air. So here pi d into L is the surface area from which the heat is transferred to the air. Then Ts is the inside surface temperature of the pipe, which is average of T1 to T6 minus Tm, which is mean bulk temperature, which is average of inlet and outlet temperature of air. So Tm is average of inlet and outlet. And Ts is surface temperature, which is average of T1 to T6. So in experiment, T6 will get by measuring 1 to 6. Then Tm will get by measuring Ti, To. Area, if that diameter is given, so we can calculate area, diameter and length is given. Length is that half meter. Now, how Q is determined in this experiment? So heat transfer takes place from pipe to air, and heat gained by the air is what? MCP To minus Ti. M is mass flow rate of air, Cp is specific heat of air, then To, that is outlet temperature of air, Ti, inlet temperature of air. So by estimating Q, we can use that Q here, and other parameters are known except H. So H we can determine, and that H is average heat transfer coefficient. Now in this case, To is outlet temperature, which we directly measure. Ti is also we can directly measure. Cp is constant. Then how we will get mass flow rate of air? So mass flow rate of air is equal to rho into area into velocity. So density of air into cross section area of pipe, okay, into velocity. Cross section area of the pipe is pi by 4 d square into v. Now how we will get in this experiment? Velocity equal to cd into root of twice g hw, that is manometric head. Cd is coefficient of discharge of orifice meter. Now this is head, head in terms of water, and we want to calculate velocity of air. So head of water is converted in terms of head of air, okay. So we have rho a ha upon rho w. Okay, this gives the velocity of air. So by knowing velocity, we can calculate mass flow rate, and from mass flow rate and knowing inlet outlet temperature, we can calculate heat transfer rate. Now in this equation, you know heat transfer rate from MCP delta T. And A is here surface area of pipe which transfer heat by convection. So pi d into L. Ts is average of 1 to 6 and Tm is average of inlet outlet. So H is unknown, which we can determine, and that H is average heat transfer coefficient. Now in this experiment, we can also calculate local H for experimental value. So Q is equal to H1 A T1 minus Tm. So in this case, others are known. So we can calculate H1, which is local heat transfer coefficient for location 1 on the pipe. Then we have similarly estimate H2. Okay. So in this way, further we can calculate H3, H4, H5, H6, which are the local heat transfer coefficient. So this is the experimental approach or determination of H experimentally. Now we will discuss how to calculate H theoretically. So theoretical approach in which the H is calculated by using correlation, and this is the problem in which air is flowing through the pipe, and the type of convection is forced convection, and flow is turbulent flow. So for turbulent flow and forced convection, we have Dittus-Boelter equation, and this Dittus-Boelter equation is used to calculate H. Okay, first Nusselt number and then H. So Dittus-Boelter equation is Nusselt number equal to 0.023, Reynolds number raised to 0.8, Prandtl number raised to 0.4, and the name of this correlation is Dittus-Boelter correlation, which is very important and common and used for force convection, for flow through pipe and turbulent flow. Now in this correlation, Re is Reynolds number, which is rho Vd upon mu. Okay, and velocity of air flow is V is equal to Cd root of twice GHW. HW is in terms of water manometer reading. So it is converted in terms of air, and velocity is calculated. And so now we know velocity, diameter of pipe is known. Then rho and mu are taken from the air property table at mean temperature, mean bulk temperature, which is average of inlet and outlet. And Prandtl number is given by mu Cp upon K, and this mu Cp K again taken at mean bulk temperature, which is given by average of inlet and outlet temperature of air. So all air properties are taken at mean bulk temperature. Now we know Prandtl number, we know Reynolds number, so we can calculate these two dimensionless number by taking the properties at mean bulk temperature and putting the value of Reynolds number and Prandtl number in Dittus-Boelter correlation. You will get Nusselt number, some value, Nusselt number equal to 20. Then now you know Nusselt number. Nusselt number is given by Hd by K. Okay, so Nusselt number is known, diameter is known, and K, thermal conductivity of fluid, air, is known. So we can calculate one unknown, H. Okay, so this is the method by which H is calculated, by using correlation. So this is called as theoretical method of determining heat transfer coefficient. So in this experiment, we can also determine the local H by theoretical approach, but there is no thermocouple inside to measure the temperature at near each surface point. So we are unable to calculate local H by theoretical approach. Okay, so the aim of this experiment is to determine H experimentally and theoretically, and we also discuss the heat transfer coefficient determination for average value and for local value. So average and local we can determine for the experimental method, and for theoretical we can calculate only H average. Okay, thank you.